Chapter 1. To the Castle. Drake didn't see the king's soldier coming. He was busy digging in the onion patch. He pulled out a fat, white onion. A worm crawled on it. Drake didn't mind the worm. He was the son of a farmer. His family had been growing onions in the kingdom of Bracken forever. He would spend his life digging up onions, whether he wanted to or not. Drake picked up the worm. "Hello, little guy," he said. Then he put the worm back in the dirt. "Are you Drake?" a loud voice asked behind him. Drake jumped and turned around. One of the king's soldiers rode up on a black horse. He had a yellow beard. His shirt had a gold dragon sewn on it, the symbol of King Roland the Brave. "Yes, I'm Drake," Drake said, his voice shaking. Soldiers never came to the fields, not unless a farmer was in trouble. The soldier rode up to Drake. He reached down and pulled him up onto his horse. "Hey, what are you doing?" Drake yelled. The soldier didn't answer. Drake's mother ran out of their hut. "Wait, where are you taking my boy?" she yelled. "To King Roland," the soldier said. Drake's heart jumped a little. He had always wanted to meet the king. "But he's only 8," his mother yelled. She marched up to the horse. "The king has chosen him," the soldier said. "Chosen me for what?" Drake wondered. He knew better than to ask the soldier questions. Peasants, like Drake, weren't allowed to speak unless spoken to. "The king will take good care of him," the soldier said. Then he spurred on the horse and sped off. "Drake, do as the king says," his mother called out. Drake had never been on a horse before. He held on tight. Drake's heart pumped fast as they raced through the village. They raced over the stone bridge. Finally, they stopped in front of King Roland's castle. The soldier helped Drake climb down from the horse. He opened the castle door and gave Drake a shove. They passed paintings and statues and people in fancy clothes. The soldier stomped behind Drake as they walked through the halls. Drake wanted to look at everything, but the soldier gave him a push whenever he slowed down. Then they came to some stairs. They walked down, down, down. The soldier stopped at a door. "Where are we going?" Drake finally asked. "We are not going anywhere," the soldier said. "Good luck." Then he ran back up the stairs. "Hey, what do you mean?" Drake yelled. But he was all alone. Drake looked at the big stone door. He felt afraid. But more than that, he was curious. He pushed it open and saw the face of a giant red dragon. Drake blinked. He didn't believe his eyes. Then whoosh! The dragon shot a huge fireball from his mouth. Chapter 2. The Dragon Stone. Drake dove away from the door. The fireball just missed him. "Vulcan, stand down," he heard someone yell. Drake stood up. A red-haired girl was standing in the doorway. "No more fireballs," she yelled at the dragon. He had shiny red scales and a long, thick tail. Two big wings grew out of his back. "Dragons aren't real," thought Drake. But Drake could see the dragon, and he had felt the heat from the fireball. A tall man walked past the girl. He had a long, white beard. He wore a pointy hat and a dark green robe. "Welcome, Drake," the man said. "I am Griffith, the king's wizard." Did he say wizard? Drake had so many questions. "Is that a dragon?" he asked. "He's not just a dragon," said the girl. "He's my dragon. Vulcan is the best dragon in the kingdom." "Drake, meet Rory," Griffith said. "Rory, please take Vulcan away. Tell the others I will be there shortly." "Others," Drake thought. The girl sighed. "Fine, let's go, Vulcan." She led the dragon away. Then the wizard led Drake down a dark hall. "Why am I here, sir?" Drake asked. Griffith didn't answer. He stopped in front of a door. Griffith pointed at its big brass lock. Sparks flew from his finger. The lock opened. Drake's eyes grew wide. Wizard magic, he thought. He followed Griffith into a room piled high with strange things. He saw bottles filled with colorful waters and powders. Griffith picked up a wooden box. The box was carved with pictures of dragons. "This is why you are here," he said. opening the box. Drake peered inside. A green stone as big as his head glittered in the light. "This dragonstone told me you have the heart of a dragon," said the wizard. He tapped Drake's chest. It did?" Drake asked. His eyes got big. "Yes, and those with the heart of a dragon become dragon masters for King Roland," Griffith said. Drake had heard stories about the magical dragonstone, but he had never believed they were real. Now all his questions came spilling out. "How does the stone know I have the heart of a dragon? And how did you find me? And what's a dragon master? And why does King Roland want dragon masters?" "The stone is old and mysterious," Griffith said. "Even I do not fully understand its magic. A dragon master is able to connect with dragons. As for the king, he is very fond of dragons, but he cannot control them." "So Vulcan isn't the only dragon?" Drake asked. The wizard grinned. "No, he is not." He handed Drake a green stone on a gold chain. "This is a piece of the dragon stone," he said. "It will help you connect with your dragon." Drake's heart jumped. "My dragon? I get a dragon?" he thought. He slipped the stone into his pocket. "Be careful, Drake," the wizard warned. "Dragons are dangerous, and even the dragonstone can't protect you from their powers." "What powers?" Drake asked. The wizard led him away without another word. Chapter 3. More Dragons. Drake's mind was spinning as he left the wizard's workshop. He followed Griffith to a big underground room. There were no windows. Torches hung on the walls. Drake saw Rory and Vulcan. He also saw two more kids and two more dragons. "Drake, this is Beau," Griffith said, pointing to a boy with black hair, "and his dragon, Shu." Beau was petting his dragon's tail. This dragon had shiny blue scales, but no wings. "Hi," Drake said. "Nice to meet you, Drake," the boy said politely. Griffith led Drake over to a girl with long black hair. Her dragon had white scales. A yellow band of scales circled the dragon's neck. The tips of its wings were yellow, too. "This is Anna and her dragon Kepri," Griffith said. Drake nodded high, he said. "We could use someone new around here," Anna said with a grin. "Dragon masters and their dragons. It is time for you to meet your dragon," Griffith said. Drake's heart pounded. "My family will never believe this," he thought. "Just this morning, I was digging onions. Now I have ridden a horse. I've met a wizard. I've seen the Dragonstone. And I'm going to have my very own dragon?" He and the other dragon masters followed Griffith down another dark hallway. "The dragons sleep in caves when they're not training," Beau explained as they walked. "Vulcan's cave is the biggest," bragged Rory. Griffith stopped in front of a small cave. Wood bars covered the cave. "Drake, meet your dragon," the wizard said.